For control applications which are communicating only with low speed, 10Base T1S is the next big step for automotive Ethernet. If you are new to 10Base T1S, this video will help you to understand the basics and motivation of this technology. Stay tuned! Hi, I'm Matthias Schwedt, product manager of the Vector Ethernet interfaces. With 100Base T1 and 1000Base T1, automotive Ethernet has successfully found its way into the vehicle. 10Base T1S is the next big step for automotive Ethernet. But the question is, why is a 10 megabit technology needed when 100Base T1 or classical bus systems like CAN or FlexRay can cover this application area already? And why exchange the advantages of switch networks again for a bus topology? I'm talking about advantages like collision-free communication, optimal throughput, or large scaling. I will explain it to you in more detail. There are two main motivations. First, a lean communication structure by means of Ethernet. No expensive and complex technology transitions through gateways when using classic bus systems beside automotive Ethernet. Second, it's all about costs. 100Base T1 Ethernet hits a sweet spot in automotive applications, but 100Base T1 is expensive compared to classic bus systems like CAN or FlexRay. So 10Base T1S will address both motivations, since for control applications most likely less than 100 megabit bandwidth is required. And these specific low-speed nodes still make up the vast majority in today's vehicles. For every networking technology that uses a bus connection for communication, it must be weighed up whether collisions of the messages on the medium are accepted, for example, to keep the overall principle simple, or whether collisions on the medium are excluded via additional mechanisms, for example, FlexRay. Since a solution with collisions is inefficient in terms of the usable bandwidth, an additional mechanism can significantly increase efficiency here. In 10Base T1S, this is addressed by using an appropriate mechanism, the so-called PLCA layer. This allows each node to send its data packets collision-free into the network, between a standard Ethernet MAC controller that works in half-duplex mode, and the data line is an additional control layer that controls the access to the bus, the file-level collision avoidance, PLCA. Let's look at the principle in more detail. On the bus itself, two kinds of participants are involved. A coordinator node that starts the cycle with a so-called beacon, and the drop nodes, which participate based on unique node IDs and send out frames at a certain point of time in the cycle. With this general framework, a bus cycle has a well-known maximum temporal length, whereby the maximum latency of the participants among each other is known. However, from cycle to cycle, this latency can also be smaller. For example, if a drop node has no data to send, or because the frame length of the data packets vary. This principle ensures for the overlying application that the relevant data can arrive regularly in a guaranteed time. To finalize, some short technical facts for your successful first setup. Typically, a maximum of 8 nodes are used in an automotive network. The total length of the bus cabling must not exceed 25 meters. The stub length, for example, the length between the bus cable and the subscriber, must not exceed 10 centimeters. All cables used must have an impedance of 100 ohms. And the most important point, the bus must be terminated with 100 ohms on both ends. Optimal test, simulation and analysis solutions for 10Base T1S are offered by the Vector tools, consisting of the interface hardware and Vector Canoe. That was a quick overview of the 10Base T1S technology. Thanks for watching! If you are interested in automotive Ethernet, you can find more videos on our channel. Subscribe and hit the bell to not miss upcoming videos. Thanks for watching.